millimeters of mercury. There are two types that we measure. It's systolic and diastolic. Systolic pressure is the highest arterial pressure during each heartbeat, and diastolic is the lowest. Heart rate is the number of the contractions of the heart muscle per minute, and it can vary depending on sleep, activity, stress. During sleep, it can go lower to about 40 beats per minute. The normal resting heart rate in adult is ranged from 60 to 90 beats per minute. So I did two studies. In the first one, I studied the precision of some blood pressure measuring devices, and in the second one, I studied changes in blood pressure and pulse after getting up. So this is the first one. I measured blood pressure in 49 students. They were 14 or 15 years old, and I measured their blood pressure after at least 10 minutes of resting with three different devices. So these are the devices that I used. They are
clarify questions of the opponent. The graph slide.
You mean with the chart, number 9.
One of the things that I didn't choose, but I looked up on the internet.
Okay, next stage is the preparation of the opponents. You have 3 minutes.
Okay, and all of them are working. So why would you test it in some others?
Because others are not used quite as often. There are some invasive ways to measure the blood pressure as well. And this was the easiest, and it wasn't painful.
Okay. And do you think that if you change the principle, methods of measuring blood pressure, it would be different if you measured it?
The transvasive blood pressure measurement is probably 100% accurate. These ones aren't 100% accurate, but those are used all the time. So I think the measurements would be different, but they shouldn't be a lot different.
So the next one is difference in the blood pressure.
Can you please speak up?
Yes. Just speak loud. Thank
you. Okay. Do you think that blood pressure will be different when we are staying or when we are crying?
It is different.
Okay. Yes, you will.
Because when we are running, our muscles need a lot more oxygen, which is dissolved in blood. So our muscles need oxygen, our cells need everything that is in blood. So our heart has to pump a lot faster than if we are standing.
Okay, that would be what to do with blood pressure if you're standing and going only one hand?
I don't think. On which arm are you measuring the blood pressure? The one which we are moving or the other one?
The other one.
Yes, I don't think it would change significantly because it's just an arm. But the blood pressure device wouldn't be able to read the pulse.
Okay.
Okay, preparation of the reviewer, clarifying questions of the reviewer, you have 2 minutes.
Can you tell me about your investigation about heart rate?
Okay, you have 2 minutes.
So I think you did a good job, but not the best, because you should be put in categories, I don't know, by BMI or their mass, or if they do some sports or not. You should write down values and limit values of high blood pressure and
questions.
That's it.
Okay. Okay, and now concluding the remarks of the opponent, 1 minute.
Okay, so thank you, and I also want to mention that I forgot to say that maybe important for her experiment will be if she uses different methods of measuring blood pressure. Because problem says to test different.
Okay, thank you. Concluding the remarks of the reporter, 1 minute. Okay, thank you. And now are the clarifying questions of the jury. So, Domagoj, do you have questions?
Yeah. Can you go to the slide with the charge, the charts regarding the blood pressure pulse of go to the, I believe, 12th slide or something like that. Your presentation.
How do I, there's no
like... can't you scroll on the mice? Okay. Then do you see this? I don't know. Okay, can you tell me what can I see actually on the X axis? Yes, because I can't read it. Could you just please read it to me if it's possible?
It says average pulse after laying down, average pulse after getting up, and average pulse after standing.
Okay, so as we can see, when we take the average, what can you say about it? Are there like differences? Are there significant? What do you expect about it?
I think the differences, there are some differences. Like I said, blood pressure increases when we are getting up and decreases while we are standing. But those are not huge differences.
Okay. Can you go to the 14th slide? So what did you do everything here? What did you put on the charts? Can you again read the x-axis?
It says after, this is systolic blood pressure, all of it.
Uh-huh, and these are the ones which are like having sports and which are not, right?
Yes, these are in categories like playing sports and red are not playing sports.
Okay, okay, great. So we see here some difference. This is really nice. So the blue ones are the ones who are doing sports. Yeah. One just thing I want to mention is that you should put all the letters a little bit bigger, like the font size should be bigger, just in case for later. Okay. The thing is, do you believe that only sports affects the blood pressure pulse? So do you have any other ideas what everything else could affect it, like? What would you suggest for another further study and everything, to categorize them into some groups?
The next experiment I'm going to do is I'm going to take three boys that are going to be approximately the same age.
Okay.
And they will be playing sports. They're about the same height and the same weight. So weight, height, even emotions can affect. Mm-hmm.
And do you believe, okay, these are some good things you like wanted to eliminate to that they don't affect the results. Do you believe that, for example, what about the diet or the eating habits? Do you think that they could affect the blood pressure?
I think
in our blood vessels, and the heart will have to pump faster, and the blood pressure will increase.
Okay, right. Can you tell me? Elena had this question, but could you repeat one more time the answer to me? What did you want to accomplish with only measurements with egg layers?
I wanted to eliminate age, because age affects blood pressure significantly. Younger kids and younger people have, I think, lower blood pressure than the older one. Like kids who are 5 years old, their blood pressure is a lot lower than from the adults. So I wanted to eliminate the age.
Okay, and when we don't look so far abroad, for years and everything, when you just look at a day, why does the time, pulse or blood pressure changes through the day? What do you believe the reason of it is? What is forcing it to change the blood pressure?
I think when the night time comes, our blood pressure and heart rate automatically lower, because our body is preparing to go to sleep. And in the morning, it's the most active, so it's again.
And what's the most basic function actually of this blood pressure? Why do we have some blood pressure? Why is the heart pumping? Why do we need to pump? Why do we have blood actually?
Because our cells need oxygen and minerals and vitamins, which are dissolved.
Mm-hmm. Are there the only the things the cells need, or are there other stuff in the blood? What do you believe?
There is also platelets, which help with clotting.
Okay.
There is white blood count, which helps us fight off viruses, bacteria, infections.
Okay, immune system. Okay.
There is red blood cells that carry oxygen on them, hemoglobin. We need blood.
Okay. Do you have any more questions?
yes, I do. A few. I have a question for the review. So you mentioned that you did your study just on the 14 to 15 year olds. Well, my question is just how do you expect that your measurements would reflect on older people, say 30s, 40s, 50s?
Older people may have some illnesses that will affect the measurements, and younger people, I think, are healthier.
In general? Okay, but do you think that the difference between
I think the measurements would be higher.
Higher, but do you think that the difference between people that are doing sports and people that are not, do you think the difference would be greater?
Yes, I do think, because especially in older people who are playing sports, most of their life will have a slower heart rate.
Okay. And just one more question for Marko. You mentioned, if I recall correctly, BMI. Could you just tell us a bit about BMI, and how do you think that it would reflect on this study?
BMI is, I don't know how to say it. If BMI is higher, the blood pressure will be higher.
That's your expectation?
Yes.
Okay.
Ana, do you have questions?
Actually, I do. You mentioned you did your research with three different devices, right? And these results, are those only for one? device?
I did two different studies. In the first one, I used three different devices because I tried to investigate accuracy or precision of those three devices. And in the second one, I used only one device on the program and three weeping on them.
Okay, so these results are only measured with one device?
Yes.
That's all?
Okay. Suggestion?
yeah, sure.
It would be perhaps useful to just say somewhere which device is used. Because it wasn't quite clear. Oh, it was okay.
Okay, then there are my questions. So first, can you go to the slide 13? Okay, the average of the middle column is 93. Yes. And can you go now to the slide 14? And now you have middle, first one has average 122 and the second have 121. So. Oh, this is heartbeat and this is MG. Okay, thanks. But what about the... did you made a graph of pulses for those two categories that you distinguished in this slide?
I did not. Perhaps I could do that for the next time.
Okay, so you could use statistical tests to prove if the the differences are relevant or not. Can you go to the slide 9? Yes. Yeah, so the ordinal number is what?
The first, the second, the third.
And is this graph relevant for us? You could sort it as you want it. So it's relevant, sorry. So what information does this graph give you?
It shows that the results from different blood pressure, from different blood pressure measuring devices are different, they're not the same. So when it's the, I read that the significant difference is more than 5 millimeters of mercury, but here we can see there's a lot of difference.
So maybe you should use some other technique to show your data, because when some looks at this graph, okay, they see three lines. They cannot see if one is always lower than the other, or okay, some can see that some methods have a larger amplitude, maybe. But maybe try to use some other methods, like we can discuss that later. So what's the difference between accuracy and precision?
I'm not sure how to explain it.
Okay, try in Croatian then.
Or you can use a
border.
I remember in the test that we had two. And then people were shooting at those, and this shooter was more precise, and this one was more accurate.
Okay, so the standard deviation of the first shooter is smaller, and the average of the second shooter is like the exact value of. What was your method to determine accuracy?
I didn't determine accuracy because I don't know what the accurate, what someone's exact blood pressure is, because if I wanted to know that, I think it would have to be an invasive test?
Well, you could compare more methods and see what's the most likely result of all methods. So.
Yes, this is what the conclusion next experiment will be now.
Okay, but I cannot see it from here. And also try not to use the whole sentences in the presentation. And do you know maybe on what is Bernoulli equation?
What's that?
Bernoulli equation of pressure.
The standard deviation.
No, no. Bernoulli equation that describes the pressure in a system. No, okay, we'll teach you that.
I know the one that we, I think I remember the one that we did in physics. But
yes, in physics. So what are two components, if you know? So one is dependent on speed, one is atmospheric pressure, or the pressure on...
Okay, we didn't do that.
No.
It had just three things,
blood pressure,
plosh
tino
I... It was the basic formula for pressure. Surface...
on the pressure,
and
yes, okay, pulse. Okay.
Yes, we did that.
So, okay, yeah. We'll teach you that too, okay. Opponent, you had the good points and nice teamwork. I'll need to revise your opponents just to see if I can give you some comments. Marco, you were unclear. You were speaking unclearly. Do you know what were the discussion questions?
Yes, but...
Okay, next time try to note it maybe. On the paper or something.